Hello friends, welcome to my channel, Myself Parag Jambulkar. In this video, we will see fundamentals of subprograms. So in this video, first we will see characteristics of subprograms, and after that, we will see some terminologies which are related to subprograms. So first, we will see characteristics of subprograms. So first characteristic is each subprogram has a single entry point. Now see, look at this example. So this is a subprogram. So in previous video, we have seen there are two types of subprogram. One is a function and another is a procedure. If it has a return type, then we call it function. If it does not have a return type, then we call it procedure. Now see, from this main subprogram, or from this main, we are calling this add function. Now look at this. Here we are calling it. So whenever this function is called, whenever this subprogram is called, so always there is single entry point. So always here we will come, and after that we will start executing the statements like this. So first statement will get executed, then second, then third, like this. It will never happen that will start executing the statements in between. So it will not happen like this. So we are executing these statements from the middle. Always it will start execution from the first statement. So first we'll have some variables. Allocation of variables will be there. After allocating these values to these variables, after that we'll start execution from the first statement, then second, then third. So every subprogram have single entry point. That's the first characteristic. Then second characteristic is the calling program unit is suspended during the execution of the called subprogram, which implies that there is only one subprogram in execution at any given time. Now see, our execution, this is C language code. So execution will start from the main function, and execution will be like this. This is called as active subprogram, as we are executing this. Whenever this another subprogram is called, so here we are calling that subprogram. So whenever subprogram is called, control will go here, and now this will be active subprogram. So by that time it will get suspended. So at a time, there is only one subprogram which is active. So calling subprogram will be inactive, or it will get suspended. So that is the second characteristic. Then third is, control always returns to the caller when subprogram execution terminates. So whenever execution of this subprogram is terminated or it is over, control goes to the calling subprogram. So as this subprogram is calling this subprogram, so whenever it has completed its execution, control will go to the calling subprogram. So that is the third characteristic. So these are the characteristics of subprogram. Now we will see some terminologies. So first is subprogram call. So subprogram call means calling statement. It is an explicit request to a specific subprogram. So in this our example, this is the subprogram call. Then active subprogram. So as I have told before, at any time instance, only one subprogram is active. So in this case, first this will be active, and after that when this subprogram is called, this will be active. So at a time there will be only one subprogram that is active. So this is called as active subprogram. Subprogram which is in execution, that is called as active subprogram. Then third is subprogram header. Now look at this. So this is the definition of subprogram. So this is called as subprogram header. this is called as subprogram header, while this is called as body of subprogram. This is subprogram header, while this is called as subprogram body. Now see, in our C language, subprogram header is written like this, while in some other languages it is written by using different keywords. So for example, in Python language, header is written like this. Subprogram header is written like this, and for that we use this keyword def, def. In Ruby again, subprogram is started with def, while in JavaScript that subprogram start with keyword function. And C language already that we know, we write header like this. Now next part is body of subprogram. So that I have told, in C language body we write in this curly braces, while in some other programming languages, so here you can see in Ruby, so end keyword is used to represent end of the body of a subprogram, while in Python language, so indentation is used. So indentation is used to show that body of a subprogram, and when it is over, so from the indentation we'll come to know that subprogram is over. So that definition of subprogram is given, or what actions will be done by that subprogram is mentioned by the body of subprogram. Next terminology is parameter profile. Now see, so in this case this is called as parameter profile. Parameter profile. So what are the parameters are there? So number, order and types of the formal parameter. So keep in mind, in this case these are called as the actual parameters, and these are called as formal parameters. Here actual parameter, from where we call it, so this is the actual parameters. While here x and y, these are the formal parameters. Now this formal parameters, so its type, its order, its number, it defines the parameter profile. So this is a parameter profile. Then protocol. So protocol means parameter profile plus return type. So here in this case, this is a parameter profile plus this return type. So parameter profile plus return type, combinedly it is called as protocol. Parameter profile, this plus this return type, combinedly it is called as protocol. This is called as a protocol. Now see, subprogram declaration. So here, so simple, this protocol that we write, it is a declaration. So for example, suppose in C language, after main function, if you are writing this subprogram like this, so when compiler reads this statement, so at that time the compiler is unaware about add. So compiler is not knowing anything about add function. So in this case, we need to write this protocol before the main function. So this is not the definition. This is only the declaration. Here we are declaring this function or subprogram that this is the return type, these are the parameters. So this is called as subprogram declaration. This is the subprogram declaration. So in our C language, C, C++ language, we call it prototypes. Now formal parameters, so already I have told. So here This we call formal parameters, while these are called as the actual parameter. Instead of that, suppose if we mention, suppose b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 5, and suppose we mention b and c, still these are the actual parameters only. As instead of values we have put variables, but still these are the actual parameters and these are the formal parameters. These are the formal parameters. Now see positional parameter. Now look at this. Here we are calling this function, right? So here add function we are calling. So again I am putting the values here. So suppose this is 3 and this is a 5. Now see, so whenever we are calling this function, so 3 will get allocated to x, 5 will get allocated to y, and suppose one more is there, so that will be allocated to this. Suppose instead of this, again suppose one more variable is there, suppose z, and here we are putting that, suppose 8. Now see, how it is allocated, 3 is allocated to x, 5 is get allocated to y, 8 is get allocated to z. Now based on the order of the formal actual parameters, these formal parameters get allocated values. This is called as positional parameters. When the values of actual parameters get allocated to the formal parameter based on their order, based on their position, this is called as a positional parameter. Now see, disadvantage of positional parameters is, so if there are minimum number of parameters, actual parameters or formal parameters, then it become easier. But if there are 10 parameters, 20 parameters, 100 parameters, then it may happen that we may skip some parameters, and it will become very difficult to remember all those and to mention in actual parameters or whenever we call that subprogram. So for that, solution is keyword parameter. So some programming languages supports keyword parameter. So what do my keyword parameter? So here you can see, this is the example from Python language. So here, this is a function call. Here, length, list, and sum, all these are the formal parameters. And my underscore length, my underscore array, and my underscore sum, these are the actual parameters. So here we are allocating actual parameters to the formal parameters in function call only. While in function call, directly we are allocating these actual parameters to the formal parameters. So in any order we can write, because now it is not dependent on the order. So in keyword parameter, this there is no order, it is not dependent on order. While in position parameters, we have to maintain order of actual parameters and the formal parameters. Correct order we have to mention. While in keyword parameters, in any orders we can write. It is independent of order. But one disadvantage of keyword parameters is, we have to remember formal parameters, that we should know while calling this function, we should know what are the formal parameters, because we have to write their names. So we should know what formal parameters are used in function definition or subprogram definition. Now some authors call these actual parameters as arguments. This is a one word that is used for the actual parameters, while formal parameters are called just as parameters. So these words are used. Arguments means formal actual parameters, and parameters means formal parameter. These are the names used by some authors. So In this video, we have seen fundamentals of subprograms, and here we have seen characteristics of subprograms, and also we have seen some terminologies. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.